A champion pushes to the point of exhaustion when nobody else is looking. It's not about who you are, it's about who you can become. I am Meg Wilson, and I am ready for the new season.
Starting guard, number eight, Sam Joe Robinson. Starting guard, And welcome everybody to the West Gym here at Simon Fraser University. It's GNAC Women's Basketball here on Clan TV. So glad to be with you, Howard Samura, flying solo tonight without our analyst, Zahid Vali Hashim, as Zahid will be back with us again for the next Clan home game. But flying solo here tonight as the Simon Fraser Clan gets set to meet the St. Martin Saints of Lacey, Washington. The starting lineups being introduced here with the lights low here in the West Gym. Ellen Kett had a tremendous game a few nights ago in another Simon Fraser Clan victory, and the rest of the Clan starters being announced. St. Martin's coming in here looking to start to gain some traction in the GNAC. Their record not what they wanted at, and we'll get more into the opposition as we get further along in the broadcast. But Simon Fraser currently tied with Western Washington at 6-1 for second place in the GNAC, behind Alaska Anchorage, sitting with that undefeated record. A key pivotal game here in the early portion of the 2016-17 GNAC schedule. We'll actually be able to read some of the notes and some of the items here as they bring up the house lights at the West Gym. The starters for St. Martin's will be number three, Hannah Reynolds, number 11, Sammy Jo Robinson. Number 12 is Bailey Olson, number 15, Mercedes Victor, and number 25, Ellen Johansson. Simon Fraser with Elisa Homer, Ozzie Nabucco, Meg Wilson wearing number 15, Ellen Kett as well, Rachel Fragley number 11, and set to take the opening jump for St. Martin's. It's going to be Johansson against number 32, Nabucco, and we will be underway in just moments here from the West Gym. Opening tip going to the Saints. And that's their guard in the backcourt handling the ball. A whistle early, though. We did not have a shot clock going for 5 seconds, so they're going to give St. Martin's the ball. On the sideline right in front of our broadcast location, Sammy Jo Robinson inbounding and getting it right back. Robinson back on top to number 15, Victor. Victor with a jump shot there off the back iron into the hands of Homer. And Ellen Kett as the Clan make their first foray up the floor here tonight. Trying to build on that 6-1 record with a great start for head coach Bruce Langford and company. Nabucco's drive unanswered. Kett for three off the front of the iron in a battle for a loose ball. Some nice size underneath by St. Martin's, but a great job. And that whole part there that ends up being Simon Fraser basketball, starting with Nabucco's active hands on defense, poking the ball away. So Simon Fraser now with a new shot clock, and Fragley with the basketball. Off the window, can't get the bounce. Fragley unanswered there. So keep it at zeros here. St. Martin's second trip down the floor for Reynolds. Sammy Jo Robinson, number 11, cross court again to Reynolds. Kent guarding her. They'll go to Johansson. Fradsley gets a hand in on the basketball, squares up defensively at the free throw line. And the ball turned over. Great job defensively by Simon Fraser. A great day of women's basketball is at the Centennial Top 10 tournament, the high school tournament in Coquitlam. Dashed over here for the start of this game, and can let our listeners know the Oak Bay Breakers ranked number one in province AAA rankings, winning that tournament. The big victory over Brookswood. There's Rachel Fradsley with a miss off the window, and Reynolds getting her Saints back across half court. Victor to Sammy Jo Robinson, a skip pass there to Reynolds, and Hannah Reynolds is gonna get a nice bounce as she ventures into the paint to open the scoring here with about a minute and 45 gone. 2-0 for St. Martin's, as we mentioned, out of Lacey, Washington. A longtime foe of the Clan, right through the NAIA days. Here's Meg Wilson, cross-court Homer for the three. In and out there. Great job to get a hand on a ball underneath by Ozzy Nabucco. And Ozzy showing you that athleticism, that leaping ability. You don't have to wonder any more than the fact that she takes the opening tip despite not being near the tallest player on this team, but is able to get up there and do so many great things as a freshman out of Riverside Secondary in Port Coquitlam. Johansson at the free throw line. Great quick move off the window is going to draw the contact, and I believe it's going to be Fragile underneath. We'll wait for the official's call. So indeed, Frag number 11 getting called for her first foul of the game. Some good energy here from St. Martin's to start this contest. Johansson at the free throw line makes the first. Ellen Johansson making a habit of getting to the free throw line, shoots a high percentage, knocks them both down, and the Clan in a 4-0 hole here to start early. Kent and Wilson, who had such great games in the victory over Seattle Pacific on Thursday, handling the ball there. Fragile going to get called for the travel down low. Credit Johansson, who comes up limping, for doing a solid job there, taking away any real estate from the Clan player underneath. Johansson's going to labor up the court. She can feel that ankle. She's going to play through it here as Reynolds with the basketball. Quick little handoff play for the jumper. Doesn't miss by much, but no dice there for Sammy Jo Robinson. Great move by Fragile right to the rim, and she gets the layup on a great look from Meg Wilson. And we know the passing prowess of Meg Wilson. She had 6 assists against Seattle Pacific, and you see the high post feed there on the break. Great chemistry there between the two players for the first Clan basket of the night, making 4-2. And a steal there by Wilson. She's going to bull her way up the court, and a foul's going to get called against Johansson. So a great job by Meg Wilson there. So Johansson's going to take a seat, the ankle, as we look at the replay here. Great move to the basket there. Fragile in full flight, graceful to the basket for the layup, and we thank Gabe Lynn, our producer engineer, for the great look. Fragile again off the window, and Rachel getting hot underneath. 2 for her last 2, and it's a 4-4 tie here. Clan finding something that works in the half court, and they are exploiting it against St. Martin's. Bailey Olson's going to kick the ball back out, to move it around the horn. Feed the post underneath, and the turnaround shot's not going to go. The rebound there by Fragile, that was Shelby Dre, who came into the game just moments ago for Johansson. That cross-court pass, so slipping through the hands of Elisa Homer. And we'll keep it knotted at 4 here, almost 4 minutes into the opening quarter of play. Reynolds, the point guard, is the transfer to Hawaii Pacific. We'll call her name a lot here tonight. There's a turnaround shot that doesn't go for Mercedes Victor. Great down the floor, running the floor hard. The bigs are finishing, and Meg Wilson with a great finish. After 2 nice finishes by Rachel Fragile, the post players for the Clan finding ways to score at 6-4 Clan as we approach the midway mark of the opening quarter. You see a grimace on the face of Elisa Homer, and I think she's going to get called for the foul on the other end of the court. Elisa getting called for the hold there. Emma Kennedy, check that Mercedes Victor with the basketball there briefly. They'll lob it down low and kick it back out for the jump shot. Now they're going to move it around, and a block shot there by Fragile. She gets in the way of Bailey Olson's jumper. Ignites the break with Ellen Kett. Kett the lob underneath. What English on the basketball by Ozzy Nabucco. And the freshman finds a way to score at St. Martin's wants time. Simon Fraser playing some fantastic basketball after falling behind 4-0, an 8-0 run, prompting a St. Martin's timeout. So a great job here to recover by the Clan. As we look at the replay here on Clan TV, you see Kent coming down the floor, the great lob, and look how high Ozzy goes off the window. She knows how to play the angles despite being a freshman. A great look at that play on Clan TV. And as we Take a look at those standings. Thank you, Gabe Lynn, for a look at those GNAC women's basketball standings. We told you about Alaska Anchorage, all alone on top. 7-0 with a 10-game win streak overall. Simon Fraser, Western Washington, each at 6-1. Seattle Pacific and Northwest Nazarene at 5-2. Follow the table down, and towards the bottom, you're going to see the St. Martin Saints. And I think we can safely tell you that there are no easy games in the GNAC, and everyone who falls into that trap ends up with an L on their record. You got to be ready to play these games. St. Martin's fell 67-53 to Western Washington at the Watkin Pavilion in Bellingham on Thursday. The score was tied 27 at the half, but a strong second half by the Vikes saw them shoot 53%. That was the difference. And with the defeat, the Saints now 5-10 overall. They're 1-6 in the GNAC. Their only conference win coming against Montana State Billings, the Yellow Jackets, on January the 7th. MSUB sporting that 2-5 record as they headed into play tonight here in a terrific GNAC conference with some great parity near the top of the table. We're back to live action. Taylor Jackson is set to check in now for the Clan on the next stoppage. Transfer out of Cal Irvine and Brookswood Secondary in Langley. Aggressive defense there from Ozzie. Knocks the ball away from Mercedes Victor. Victor's going to come out of the game, and Johansson comes back in for St. Martin's. And as we mentioned, Taylor Jackson now into the game as well. She's going to spell Rachel Fradgley. That's Emma Kennedy, number 5 on the court right now, playing a bit of guard here for this Saints team. A travel is going to get called, and a turnover there by Rebecca Baugh. So Baugh with a turnover, and the Clan with that 8-4 lead here. Great basket by Meg Wilson to prompt that St. Martin's timeout. Tia Sang, the freshman from Richmond, set the check-in. Batted away from Kett, but Ellen gets the ball back. Somehow finds Meg, and a double team comes. She kicks it out quickly. Homer wants to take the three ball. She's going to knock it down. Elisa Homer, and that's a tough shot because she mishandled the pass coming out and had to steady herself and still knocks down the triple. 11-4 the score, a 7-point lead here for the Clan. A drive on the baseline. Homer defending it. Going to go to Johansson. The turnaround shot by Johansson, not going to fall. But she chases down her own miss and gets the follow. Ozzie came defensively, but a little bit too late as Johansson's great hustle makes it 11-6, and the 11-0 Clan run is snapped here by the Johansson follow. Turnaround is not going to go for Ozzie. Battling hard underneath. Smart play by Taylor Jackson to throw it off the legs of Emma Kennedy. And that should keep the ball with the Clan for 16 more seconds on the shot clock. Take a look at that replay there, as indeed Taylor with a great play there to throw it off the legs of Kennedy, number 5. Subs into the game, Sophie Swant, Tia Sang, wearing 21 for Swant, number 1 for Sang, and they're in there, that pair in there, I'll get my words straight here, along with Meg Wilson, number 15, Taylor Jackson, number 12, and Ella Kett, number 5. Skip pass to Kett. Goes awry. They battle for that loose ball. They're going to call a jump ball. Just a little bit late, Kett thought perhaps she could get that ball to a teammate. Battling hard on the floor there with Rebecca Baugh, number 13. So Clan getting it on the alternating possession. They're going to readjust the shot clock. They're going to make it 13 seconds. So Wilson, the lob right down to Taylor. Oh, off the window. Taylor Jackson can't find the touch she wants there. And here comes St. Martin's back up the floor. Kennedy gets the ball to Johansson. She loves that sweepy move through the paint. Puts up the shot and draws the contact. Ellen Johansson can't let her gain real estate. She makes the most of it. The number 25 is stepping up to the free throw line. Make the first one. Johansson, a solid game in the loss to Western Washington. She was 6 of 13 from the field, 3 of 8 from the free throw line, but 8 trips there, 15 points for her as she misses the second one. battle again for a loose ball. They're going to call another jump ball. This time it'll go St. Martin's way. 11-7. The Saints have got the pace of the game more to their liking here. So Vanessa G now into the game for Tia Sang. Vanessa wearing number 2. She's the redshirt sophomore of Riverside in Coquitlam. Underneath the basket again. Good job there defensively, unless they call Kayla for the foul. Indeed, Jackson's going to get whistled, and right now Johansson, a bit of a wrecking crew in the paint for St. Martin's. So Johansson getting a plethora of trips, as they say here in this opening quarter of play. Good on the first, making it 11-8, a one possession game. She can make it a 2-point game here. She's gonna miss it, but the loose ball is gonna go to the Saints. They recycle the shot clock, and again, here she comes again. Johansson this time, nothing but net on the turnaround. Off the offensive rebound on the missed free throw, and those shorten the lives of coaches. They hate giving up those second chance opportunities. 11-10, St. Martin's right back in this basketball game. Kennedy getting called for the foul for St. Martin's. Emma's first up the game. Fradgley back into the game for Taylor Jackson. So Fradgley out there with Swanton Wilson. Vanessa G and Ellen Kett as well in the game right now for Simon Fraser. Swan going to Wilson up top. Mismatch there size-wise. Meg's also got the handle. Look at that. Dominance from Meg Wilson to take a guard off the dribble and find a way to score the basketball. Great job. 13-10 is the score here for Simon Fraser. Great job by Meg Wilson. Taking advantage of what was in front of her, she takes it and banks it home. Jump hook is going to swirl and fall for Shelby Dre. She's a 6'1 senior out of Phoenix, Arizona. Makes it a 1-point game here. G feeds the post. That's Wilson. Gets a quick double team. Kicks it across court. Kett wants the three ball off the side iron into the hands of G. Nice rebound. Another recycle of that shot clock. This time G for three. Bingo! Vanessa G off the bench knocks down the triple. And a big shot for Simon Fraser. Making it a 16-12 score here with 2 minutes left in the opening quarter of play. St. Martin's in the half court with Kennedy. Swant out to guard her beyond the arc. Going for the steal. Great job by G. She reaches in a hand, knocks it loose, and here's Swant. Skip pass to Fradgley down the court, and Rachel with the big basket for Simon Fraser. All from the defense of Vanessa G. Does a great job to ignite that break. And you've seen how well the Simon Fraser forwards are running the floor here today. Nice basket there. Kett with a steal, and it gets her arm wrapped around as she goes for that loose ball. They haul down Ellen Kett. The only way to stop Kett. And the foul is going to be called against Johansson. Let's take a look at that on Clan TV. Well, let's first take a look at a great shot from Vanessa G. Great job there by Vanessa to knock that one down. And thanks to Gabe Lynn for that quick look on Clan TV. Simon Fraser right back on offense. Ozzy Nabucco, number 32, back into this basketball game. She's going to feed Kett, and boy, they are all over Kett. They're manhandling her. They know how dangerous she is. So Hannah Reynolds getting called for the foul there. It's her first of the game. Fourth team foul here. 1:14 remaining in the quarter. The lob pass through the hands of Frage, but Sophie able to corral the ball. Kett feeding the post and going to the basket for another layup. It's a layup drill down low for Rachel Fradgley. And what a great job by Frage to score another basket here. 20-12. A nice run here. The Clan have recovered. Just take a look, and we're talking about those sharp cuts to the basket, how well they're moving. And look at Rachel Fradgley. Eye contact with the passer Kett from the high post. And a great run to the window for two. Foul on Ozzy Nabucco is going to send Mercedes Victor to the free throw line, and Victor rears up and hits the first one. And Victor getting set for the second. It's not going to get the roll this time, but a rebound there by Dre. Dre giving them some nice height there with or without Johansson on the floor. Important for this Saints team to try and match up against the Simon Fraser height inside. Nice shot there. Great touch by Shelby Dre down low. She finds a way to score it in the final 36 seconds of this opening quarter. Zhang up top to Nabucco. Ellen surveying the situation. Kent, great pass down low to Nabucco. And Ozzy with the make on a great look. There was some English on that pass from the top by Ellen Kett. And in the final 14 seconds, it's a 7-point clan lead. Really important for Simon Fraser to play well through the opening energy that St. Martin's is bringing here. Great turnaround move in the paint, a pivot, and Ellen Kett grabs that basketball and gets a jump ball. This time it'll go Simon Fraser's way with 2.7 seconds left in the quarter. But if you're a young leader guard out there wanting to know how to play the position at both ends of the floor, watch what Ellen Kett does, because she never nods off on a defensive assignment. You watch her there, so active with her hands. 2 seconds. Shot is good if it goes, and it won't. The shot by number 11, Sammy Jo Robinson. So that'll do it for the quarter. 22-15 our score here on Clan TV. Howard Samura with you. We'll take a short break and be back with a second quarter on Clan TV.
Fear can either drive us back or push us forward to play harder and stronger. To uncover your true potential, you must first find your own limits and then have the courage to blow past them. I am Cruz Velasquez, and I am ready for the new season.
Champions are made from something deep inside, a desire, a dream, a vision. Anything is possible if you are determined, dedicated, and if you believe in yourself. I am Lauren Swistak, and I am ready for the new season.
And we are back with here at the West Jim Howard Samura Clan TV. Happy to be with you in a great first quarter by the Simon Fraser Clan. Clan went on an 11-0 run after falling behind 4-0 and weathered a bit of a mid-first quarter doldrum, got hot again, and execution key, especially those cuts to the basket in the half court from the high post. Great passing by the Simon Fraser team in the opening quarter of play. And 10 made field goals, 8 assists on those 10 made field goals tells you how in sync Simon Fraser was in the half court and igniting the break here in the opening quarter of GNAC play. Simon Fraser, 10 of 17 from the field. St. Martin's, 5 of 11. Leading the way for the Saints with 4 points is Shelby Dre off the bench. 8 points for Rachel Fradsley, leading the way for the Clan. Rachel, 4 of 6 from the field. And that field goal percentage climbing and has to make her amongst the GNAC leaders in that category. Here's a drive by Reynolds. Comes up empty, and Kett now with the basketball. Quickly to Wilson, to Homer. Elisa with a nice triple in that opening quarter. Here's Kett. Finding Homer, Elisa thought about the three. Instead, drives, turns, finds Swant. Shot clock is now down to 10 here for the Clan. First offensive possession of the second quarter. Homer, skip, or rather pass to Kett for three off the front of the iron and into the hands of number 21, the Shyler Sullivan. And I believe Shyler seeing her first action of the game. All tipped off Swan. Wide open jumper. Nobody comes out to challenge. Sammy Jo Robinson. And Sammy Jo, a couple of bounces and knocks down the short little jumper there. 22-17. St. Martin's right in this game. They've got to keep their energy because Simon Fraser playing its best basketball of the season right now. A note to pass on, and we mentioned that as well in the pregame, Western Washington early in the game, that St. Martin's and Western were locked at 27. So some solid early play against Western and some solid early play against Simon. St. Martin's getting two toughies in a row here on the road on a two-game GNAC Thursday-Saturday trip. Skip down low to Dre. She tries to steady herself underneath, and a great job by Sam Beauchamp underneath to get the block. St. Martin's now with the basketball. They'll kick it back up top to Bailey Olson. She takes the jumper off the back of the iron into the hands of Homer for the rebound. Kett now across half court. Meg feeding the post. Beauchamp there, but a whistle blows. They're going to call a foul on Simon Fraser. Oh, no, check that. I'm sorry. It's a St. Martin's foul, and it's against Bailey Olson. It's her first of the game. Here's Kett off the inbounds. Toes the baseline, skips to Homer for three, and it's a big three for Elisa Homer. So Homer now with two triples in this game. 25-17 the score. It's an 8-point Klan lead off the big three in the assist from Ellen Kett. Olson turns the corner, finds the lane, and they are not contesting her enough. Bailey Olson shouldn't be able to score that easily against this Klan defense, but she takes what's available to her. Makes it 25-19. Beauchamp seeing some nice minutes here in the second quarter. She feeds Kett. Goes to Sam down low, and Sam Beauchamp, that's what she's got to do. Play big down low, and she extends and outreaches the St. Martin's foe down low for a nice feed down in the block for a layup. St. Martin's, though, comes right back and gets that back and more as Bailey Olson's getting on a roll here. She knocks down a triple. I believe she scored her team's last 7 points at this stage. 27-22 the score. Here's Kett for three. Ellen Kett for three! So Simon Fraser gets that one right back. Ellen Kett knocks it down. She's left unguarded. She knocks down the triple. McKenna Schultz checked at number 10, was just dribbling the ball there. She's new to the game as well. Take a look at that on Klan TV. Quick catch and shoot, confidence in the shot, and Ellen Kett, no hesitation as she puts up the big three ball. Kett was scoreless in this game. She played every minute in the opening quarter. But now with 3 points. Meg Wilson checking into the game, number 15 as well. That looks like Taylor Dryden, the point guard out of Gonzaga Prep. The freshman will pair in the backcourt with Ellen Kett. So some real youth on the floor here when you look at the relative ages of some of these Klan players, from Beauchamp to Drinan to Dabuko. Here's Drinan. Skips to Ozzy. Back up top, Ellen wants three again. She's feeling it. Ellen Kett on fire, back-to-back triples. An immediate timeout being called. We will take that time. I'll let our producer, Gabe Lynn, know that we'd love to chat about some of the sponsors that help us bring Klan TV to the air. And as we mentioned, always Nestor's Market. They are proud to be the official grocer of Simon Fraser University Athletics, the local grocery store with a full selection of items. All natural, gluten-free, organic. It's all there. Nestor's Market. Visit them today at the Cornerstone. Charter Bus Lines as well, the official motor coach of Simon Fraser University Athletics. They're proud to support every Klan team, and all the Klans travel throughout the Pacific Northwest are dedicated to providing safe and comfortable transportation to all games by Klan teams. You can visit them at charterbuslines.com. Today's game is live streamed in HD, and you can watch it at athletics.sfu.ca/live. This game also available on demand at athletics.sfu.ca/on-demand, and that is a great resource if you're a fan of the GNAC, if you're a fan of basketball, football, volleyball, whatever it may be, and you like the Simon Fraser Klan as well. All those games archived through Klan TV. And yours truly happy to be the play-by-play voice of Simon Fraser men's and women's basketball, and of course, Simon Fraser football. to get back to main action here. 6:13 left to the break, and it is a 9-point lead by the ladies in white, the Simon Fraser clan. St. Martin's really looking to get into the win column here in the GNAC, and it's not easy when you're playing back-to-back against Western and now Simon Fraser. Drive to the basket is taken away and erased. McKenna Schultz stopped there underneath by Sam Beauchamp. And Meg Wilson with a rebound will recycle it. Tip, but contained by Kett. They were looking for Sam down low. Couldn't find her, and now with Schultz. Head coach Tim Healy has run a number of options at point guard here for the St. Martin's team. Turnaround shot, trying to muscle that pass. Beauchamp, who positionally is playing great basketball right now. Right down the floor, and the quickness of Ozzy, if you're playing her for the first time, will catch you by surprise. She didn't score it there, but draws the contact. They have to do whatever they could. The speed at which Ozzy gets down the floor, and there she is on Clan TV replay. The reach over by number 12, and that was Bailey Olson. Olson gets whistled for her second as Nabucco puts up the first free throw. Checking into the game now, three players. It's going to be Hannah Reynolds, number 3, Shyler Sullivan, number 21, and DeShelby Dre, who was very effective down low, wearing number 42. So some wholesale changes here for Coach Healy and company as Nabucco knocks down the second free throw. Making a 10-point lead here, 5 minutes to go, or 5:20 to go here in this opening half of play. Reynolds with the basketball now. Cross court. Not a lot of real estate there for Sullivan. But here's one person who's thrived in it. Shelby Dre, but she couldn't get that jump hook to fall in the low block right underneath the basket. Captain Nabucco, quick move to the basket by Ozzy, and she can't get it to fall. Sam Beauchamp working hard to try and regain possession, but Ozzy's gifts are so visible there. She is so quick. She leaves her defenders flat-footed, but they come back down and knock down the three. Mercedes Victor, the Hawaiian native, says, give me three, and she does. She makes it a 7-point game. 34-27 the score. Handoff play to Kett at the top. Kett guarded by Victor. She'll go up to, oh, check that. That was Dryden. Apologies there. Kett to Wilson. Taylor now with the basketball up top. Now Ellen's got the basketball. She goes into the paint. Short little jumper off the mark. Doesn't get the friendly roll. What a rebound by Nabucco. Ozzy skies to get that in a crowd and feeds Meg for three. Meg Wilson. Or was that a two? Was that a three? That was indeed a three. Just checking with my trusted sources here. So great job there by Meg Wilson. The versatility of this Clan team, amazing to watch sometimes. Drynan finding Wilson in flight. The whistle blows and, oh, a timeout being called by the Clan. So a little bit of a stoppage in the play here as the Clan talk things over. Can let you know about some of the other events coming up here. I think we are going to be able to let you know, perhaps not. But we can let you know as it pertains to St. Martin's. We told you about them that they're 5-10 this season, they're 1-6 in the GNAC, and their only conference win coming against Montana State Billings on January the 7th. Ellen Johansson, their key player, she's averaging 13.9 points per game. She's shooting 52% from the field. 6.5 rebounds a game, 2.1 assists. Last season, St. Martin's losing both of their games to SFU. They fell 84-54 on the 16th in Lacey and lost 84-74 on the 11th here at the West Gym. Here's Drynan. Tia Sang now into the game. Coming in off of that timeout. Meg driving, scooping off the window, trying to draw the contact, couldn't get it, but great job there by Sang. Thought she had the ball, but the Shyler Sullivan checked out of St. Martin's coming up with it, and she's got the basketball right now. Rebecca Baugh to Robinson. Turnaround here from Oh, great quick move on the turnaround there by Mercedes Victor. But look at Meg go right down the floor. Meg Wilson, keep in mind she's 6'1", runs the floor like a 5'8 guard, handling the basketball, goes the full 94 as Tia Sangler is going to get called for the foul. As she was closely guarding Rebecca Baugh on that play. So let's take a quick look at a replay here on Clan TV as Meg gets the ball at about the free throw line extended. Look at her go down the floor. That's a good 76 feet that she's driving down the floor in full flight. Meg Wilson, what a player she's been for the Clan, missing all of last year with an injury. Here's Dre underneath. Sam Beauchamp, what a job defensively getting a block there and preserving the 12-point lead. And Simon Fraser down the floor. Sang cross-court pass here to Meg. Rocket pass back to Tia for the three. Doesn't go. And Sang struggling with the shot a bit. She had a great start to her campaign in the preseason. And head coach Bruce Langford and company obviously working to bring that back out of Tia Sang because she made a real big start here as a freshman. Here's Emma Kennedy back up top to Sullivan. Ball with the basketball now to Kennedy. Shot clock's down to four again. As we see a wrestling match for the ball and a jump ball called between Dre and Kett. But again, being the big iron curtain there down low was Samantha Beauchamp. Look at Sam come over, study the play, all ball. Great job defensively, a great replay from our crack staff here on Clan TV. Love to take you inside the plays that we talk about, and that was a great example there. Here's Meg Wilson, 1:45 from the half. Tia Sang faking the pass on the baseline up top to Drinan. Meg driving through traffic off the window, and what an acrobatic, athletic play by Meg Wilson. She splits the defense, and as she squares herself in midair, makes the ball go in off the window. Traveling call there against Rebecca Baugh. She's not happy about that. Wilson, what a play to square yourself. And that's the tough part about that shot is as you turn the corner, trying to square yourself and maintaining your poise. Let's take a look at it. Beauchamp with the basketball there. And tough, tough shot to hit as she splits the defense and turns her shoulders towards the basket by Meg Wilson. Here's Drinan. Vanessa G to Samantha Beauchamp. Foul being called against Shyler Sullivan, number 21. And hey, can you see it maybe a little bit? The confidence growing in Samantha Beauchamp. This is one of... You know, the points to me aren't the huge thing. It's the way that she's playing on defense and how that's translating on the offensive end of the floor. That's a big smile. Sam Beauchamp flashes at the Simon Fraser bench and all her teammates as she comes down the floor. Makes the N1 play after making several great defensive plays and positionally sound here. She's been excellent here in the opening half of play. Kayla Jackson now on the floor defending. That's number 30, Mallory Kessler. Dre's fall away doesn't go, and Vanessa G with the rebound there. So number two with a nice rebound, brings it over half court. Ellen Kett not on the floor, so a great opportunity here for the freshman Drinan to show her stuff. Great pass there, and Taylor can't finish it, but Sam Beauchamp does. But Tia Sang made, or rather Vanessa G made a great pass. Down low, Taylor couldn't finish it, but Beauchamp there to clean it up underneath. Sam Beauchamp's had a terrific first half of play. We hope to have an interview for you, and I'm not too sure when, but it'll be at halftime at some stage. We'll potentially get a Clan player. Not too sure who we're getting at this point, but we will certainly endeavor to do that. Great pass by Sam underneath, and that's going to be for a scored basket by Sophie Swant. Sam's doing it all right now. What a great opening half from Samantha Beauchamp. Is that score correct? 48-27. I've been talking too much. I haven't been looking at the scoreboard. What a surge by the Clan here. Sophie Swant unable to make that free throw, but is a 21-point lead at the half at 48-27 by this Simon Fraser Clan team. And what a start for the Simon Fraser Clan. Their young fans all lined up in the tunnel and awaiting them. What a great first half of play that was. And I'm not too sure who we're getting as an interview. Oh, start of the half. Okay. Well, apparently we're going to have our interview with Sam Beauchamp at the start of the second half. When the players come out of the locker room, we'll try and get Sam for you and talk things over, talk to her about that great first half. We will run through some of the numbers here very quickly before we go to break. And just to let you know, the top Clan scorers in that first half, Meg Wilson leading the way. She's 5 of 6 from the field. Rachel Fradgley is 4 of 6, and she's got 8 points. Elisa Homer with 6, Ellen Kett with 6, and Sam Beauchamp with 7. Sam, 3 of 3. You heard all those great numbers. It's no surprise. The Clan are shooting 61% from the field, 20 of 33. And no double-figure scores for St. Martin's. They're led by the 8 points of Ellen Johansson. So a quick break here. We'll be back with more before the start of the second half. Howard Samura here with you from the West Gym at Simon Fraser on Clan TV.
Success is dependent upon drive and persistence. The secret to winning is having the extra energy to make another effort or try another approach. I am Addie Townsend, and I am ready for the new season.
alright.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
Great leaders know their strengths and can call on the right strength at the right time. It's about setting an example to influence others so they can be better. I am Devin May, and I am ready for the new season.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect, it's the name of the game.
Strong character is created little by little, day by day. It is pushing through physical and mental pain, agonizing losses, and repetitive practices. I am JJ Pankratz, and I am ready for the new season.
A true champion puts every ounce of sweat and effort into the goal. Find your passion, become one with it, and great things will happen. I am Kevin Vigna, and I am ready for the new season.
And back with you at the West, Jim Howard Samura here on Clan TV. It's a 48-27 lead at the half, a terrific outing by the Simon Fraser Clan, who went on a big run in the latter stages of the second quarter of play, and what a great job by the Clan. 14 points off of turnovers to none, an advantage there against St. Martin's, who they lead by a big total here at the break. Simon Fraser the edge in points in the paint, 28-14. As well, that Simon Fraser bench supplying 12 of the team's 48 points. So one quarter of their scoring coming from the bench. And we're hoping to be joined in a moment here by Samantha Beauchamp. Whenever we're ready, we can actually do that right now. Why don't we do that right now? And we'll welcome the Simon Fraser player of Holy Cross in Surrey. Samantha, thank you for joining us on Clan TV.
No problem.
Talk about the opening half, the energy you guys had, especially late in that second quarter. You really got on a roll. Everybody did. What was that all about?
I think it's a lot of a team effort. It starts on the bench, and then it works with the plays we do, and the fast breaks and all the effort we bring starts on defense and ends on offense.
Your play positionally, defensively, and getting some key blocks in that first half, how is that part of your game coming along? How happy are you with that part right now?
I think there's always room for improvement.
What does that lead to? Maybe my next question. It looks like it leads to more aggressiveness from you at the other end of the court.
Yeah, I'd say it does.
How happy were you with the N1 play? Maybe talk about that and kind of how...
Yeah, we've worked on that a lot in practice. It's something that the posts that we're working on, so it's good to see in a game.
And if I'm not mistaken, that was a pretty big smile you flashed at the bench.
Yeah. Jess has really been working on that with us.
So good to see it happen in the games. What do you guys have to do, last question, to keep things going in the second half?
Once again, it's defensive rebounds leads to offense.
And that's Sam Beauchamp joining us here. Thank you very much. All the best in the second half.
Thank you.
That is Samantha Beauchamp, and we thank her for being a guest with us on Clan TV. We will stay with you here. 1:20 of the second half of play. Howard Samura here with you. We'll continue to run through some of the numbers from that opening half of play, and I'll just let Gabe Lynn know that we've lost our replay monitor here courtside. The screen has gone blank. Hopefully we can get that replay monitor up and running before the start of the second half, because we love to talk to you about the plays that we see on the replays on Clan TV. Should emphasize again that 61% shooting percentage. It was 62.5% from the field in the second half of play, in the second quarter, check that, where Simon Fraser was 10 of 16 from the field. So a great job there by the Clan, just as a team, everybody shooting the ball so well. The Clan also, we should say, 6 of 9 from beyond the arc. So they're shooting a great percentage, whatever they're doing here right now. We'll hopefully, I just got a message in my ear from our producer, Gabe, that we will endeavor to get that replay screen up. Hopefully we can get that going as the teams get down to 15 seconds as they come out onto the floor. St. Martin's is going to start with possession. And it looks like the starters back on the floor for both teams. Indeed, Hannah Reynolds, number 5, Sammy Joe Robinson, 11, Bailey Olson, 12, Mercedes Victor is 15, and number 25, Ellen Johansson, all on the floor here for the St. Martin Saints as we get underway in the second half. A jumper there is not going to go for St. Martin's. A battle for a loose ball, and Elisa Homer, number 4, comes up with the basketball. In control as she normally is from that point guard spot, feeds Homer. Victor guarding her, the pass up top to Ozzy Nabucco. Meg Wilson, who's flashed a lot in that opening half out there as well. Here's the three ball from Ellen Kett. A little shy off the front of the iron, and St. Martin's with Olson right back down the floor to Reynolds. Here's Johansson. Olson coming a long way to get that pass, feeds Johansson on the block, the turnaround shot to Victor. Mercedes driving into a double team and somehow finds a way to score the basketball in traffic. A great job there by Mercedes Victor. Simon Fraser now in the half court. They're going to find Kenegain Ellen for three off the back of the iron. The ball knocked out of bounds by Mercedes Victor. I think it's going to stay with Simon Fraser. And we have our replay back up. Great to have that. And with our thanks to Jessica Smith for coming down and figuring out how to get the replay monitor going again. So glad to have that going again. We're in full flight here on Clan TV. The three ball from Elisa Homer. And some fireworks in the start here, the third quarter for Simon Fraser, as Homer knocks down a big triple there, 51-29. Sammy Joe with a turnover there, Robinson, and the ball right into the hands of Fradsley. She feeds DeBucco. And maybe running the break and finding a speeding guard, there's one thing that, not saying Fradsley can't do, but doesn't do often, that would be that, but a bit off there in the pass to DeBucco, and the ball turned over now. So Simon Fraser getting back on defense here against Johansson, drives by Fradsley off the window, and that's a great skill set there, reminiscent of Meg Wilson on the baseline. Ellen Johansson getting it done with a great drive on the baseline for the layup. 20-point lead here for Simon Fraser, 51-31. Kent feeds Nabucco, who comes a long way to gain control to Homer. Wanted to step back three, instead back to Ellen. A couple of bounces off the foot of number 11, Sammy Joe Robinson. Nice crowd in the house here today for this Saturday night contest. Kent to inbound right underneath the basket to Fradsley, and Rachel Fradsley miss a matchup she favors in a quick, easy basket off the inbounds to make it a 32-point lead, or a 22-point lead, check that. Johansson gets called for the travel. She's a little dumbfounded by that. Looks over at head coach Tim Healy like, what was that? Her thoughts on that play. Not happy with the turnover there on a routine play. Kent coming across half court. Feeds Fradsley at the three-point line. Hand off to Kent. Victor stays with her as Kent zigzags, great pass down low to Fresley, high off the window, and Rachel plays the angle beautifully for the layup. So 55-31 now the score, Simon Fraser in control. Well, take a look at the replay here on Clan TV, but I'll tell you, Bailey Olson's look of incredulity on that play was amazing. Great play there by Fradsley, but Olson turns the ball over on a travel right after Johansson did, and both of the St. Martin's players wondering what they're doing wrong. Kent misses on the drive, and Johansson now with the basketball. Feeding the post, a turnaround effort is gonna go. Bailey Olson, quick decisive move there, squares up on the turnaround. 55-33, Nabucco in a sprint down the floor, couldn't squeeze it. So a couple times down the floor here, the Clan falling short of their execution. Kent with a nice baseline drive in the midst of a layup, and this time trying to feed Ozzy for the quick deuce. Clan, what are they gonna do defensively? You're gonna get called for a block, and I believe Nabucco is gonna get called for that block. Tried to rely on her quickness and the position just wasn't there. We'll see who Sophie Swan comes in for. Indeed, it will be Ozzy Nabucco. Tia Sang also into the game for Elisa Homer. So Homer and Nabucco out of the game. There is some real energy rebounding potential with that group of Wilson, Swant, and Fradsley right now on the floor. If you put Ozzy in with that group, Simon Fraser, rebounding percentage-wise, really ups the ante, but this group's solid as well. And Kent is an excellent rebound to the point guard. And she's got the ball right now, number five, quickly to Tia Sang. Tia gives it back to Kent, works off that Fradsley screen, skip to Rachel for the lay-in! And a great quick developing play in the half court. But that instant recognition, it's like you're flicking a switch, the play is turned, and there goes Frage to the basket for the lay-in. On the other side, though, they're going to get it right back with Mercedes Victor, the short baseline jumper, uncontested. Here's Swan trying to finish on the break. Turnover there as she went looking for Sang on the other side of the floor. St. Martin's wants a fast break opportunity. Can't get it, but they'll get Johansson. She's going to drive against Fragley. Tough shot fading, and Frage with a great job defensively to take it all away from Johansson. Simon quickly down the floor, Sang up top. Great look down low, and the reverse goes. Meg Wilson from the high post to Rachel Fragley. And what a look, what a bullet from Meg, and a great turnaround move on the reverse lay-in by Rachel Fragley, 59-35. That's the hoop of the night here thus far. Simon Fraser, though, giving up stuff on the other end. They're trading right now. And Victor quickly got those two back. Tia Sang for three. Swirling in and out. Kett with a rebound off the window, and Ellen Kett. Nobody gets to Ellen Kett, and she swoops under the basket for the lay-in. If Simon Fraser needs to do anything right now, it's stop the response, and they do that with a steal. Meg jumps the passing lane. She's driving in against the guard, Reynolds, and she's going to body up and score at 94 feet for Meg Wilson. What a terrific burst there from Wilson to anticipate, get right down the floor, and then use her physicality at the end to finish that play against the lead guard of this St. Martin's team, and she's going to come back and get those three back. Hannah Reynolds, good for her. If you're on the playground, she's got those points back and more. She comes back down, hits a three. Here's Swant's turnaround. Sophie gets clobbered. Mercedes Victor with a foul. Let's take a look at a basket here on Clan TV as Sang drives, and a great look. Our Clan crew getting everything that's happening here on the floor tonight. That is a great look underneath on that high post pass from Meg Wilson. The communication she's established with Rachel Fragley. The high-low in the high gear here tonight at the West Gym. Simon Fraser, 63-40, the 23-point lead amongst their largest of the night. Simon Fraser's largest lead, 21, so 23 points, their largest of the night right now. They're playing great basketball as they chat things over in the huddle. I think we've got another surprise coming up here on Clan TV. We'll take a look and see what this one is. It's Ellen Kett driving, finding the lane, and going to Fragley. There are so many great things working with this Clan team right now. If you're a fan of this team, it's hard not to get excited when you see their execution, their level of execution, and not only that, but the versatility of these athletes. And there's also that intangible factor. There is a gutsy tenacity here among the group. As I talked to Julie Heisey, the Seattle Pacific head coach, after their loss here to Simon Fraser, a decisive loss for Seattle Pacific, despite both teams being 5-1 at the time, and Seattle Pacific coming in number 14 in the national rankings. And Julie Heisey said one of the best defensive teams Bruce Langford has had up here on the hill that she has seen. And it's the athleticism, so many different things combined. As we look at those standings again, Seattle Pacific still very much the threat, sitting there at 5-2, but Simon Fraser took care of business. They want to get the sweep here this weekend, and they've gotten off to a good start here with a 25-point lead here. I think we're back. Indeed, we are back, but we've lost our replay screen again. Apologies for the gremlins here atop Burnaby Mountain tonight. They're crawling in on the audio gear here and making our job a little bit tougher as Taylor Drinan now set to check in for the Clan. So the Clan getting things done offensively with a 68-40 lead, the biggest lead of the game here. We'll try and focus back on the action. Skip pass down low for St. Martin's. A turnaround shot draws the contact underneath, and that's Mallory Kessler with a turnaround effort. So Meg Wilson picks up her second foul of the game. And good on St. Martin's for upping the physical ante down low. It's what they need to do here. Simon Fraser has had an answer for so much of the St. Martin's attack tonight, but Kessler makes the first free throw. So Dryden number three, the freshman checks in for the veteran Kett number five. As well, Elisa Homer number four, the Handsworth Royal product out of North Vancouver. The junior checks in for Tia Sang, and we thank Zahid Valihasim for some stats here. Simon Fraser still shooting over 60%, 61.4% from the field as Kessler misses on the second. She's one of two, 68-41. 3:20 left here in the third quarter. Simon Fraser in white, getting things done. Here's Dryden working off the Swan screen to Homer at the top. Taylor to Swan now with the basketball. Cross court to Wilson, little fake. Feeding Taylor Jackson down on the low block. Taylor's turnaround move, and you gotta credit the physical presence of Dre and Kessler as they came at Taylor Jackson. Helen Kett with 11 assists in this game, and we should let you know the GNAC record for assists in the game, 16 by Allie Schmidt of Central Washington in 2012, so Ellen Kett's got some time here, although with the margin of lead, it's not too sure how much she's going to play. It's a great opportunity for Dryden, especially the freshman, to get in there. But Kett, five assists away from the GNAC record. Just some early distant warning for you from our stats department here. Wilson with a great foray to the basket. And Meg sensing blood there, goes right to the window for the layup. Turnaround drive there, they'll kick it back out, intercepted by Sophie, and Swant right down the floor, finds the trailer. Homer wanted the three ball, instead Wilson to Dryden. Taylor for three, bingo, Taylor Dryden with a big triple. And Simon Fraser makes something happen. So many options there, they were poised, they were patient, they found the best option on the floor. It was Taylor for the triple, and she knocks it down, 73-41 the score. Emma Kennedy now driving against Homer, little runner. Not gonna go, but the whistle blows, and looks like Taylor stepped in there and drew the charge. And the SFU bench up to applaud that, as we'll take a look at it, I hope, on Clan TV. And back with you again on Clan TV as Homer to Dryden. Taylor's three is not going to go this time. And again, we thank our crack staff here on Media Row for getting us back. And there's a triple from Meg Wilson. So a big triple there, 76-41. And great to have our video replay. I think I have to not move too much here. Everything's in a fragile state, as I think it's being held together with tape and glue and paper clips right now, but that's okay, we'll get through. The final 11 minutes here is Samantha Beauchamp, our halftime guest, coming into the game. And Samantha, some great insights as to what's happening with the emotional kind of quotient of the Simon Fraser defense. Everybody getting really pumped to play some defense, and as Samantha says, really helps her play on the offensive end of the floor. So Meg taking a well-deserved rest here as Samantha Beauchamp into the game now. Here's Homer with the basketball. Puts up a triple and knocks it down! Nothing but net for Elisa Homer. A big triple. And of course, Homer last year among the best in the nation. percentage-wise and content-wise, too. Tons of volume on the triples. Knocks down a big one there. And this time, Swant with another steal. Feeds Drinan in midcourt. Has it knocked away from behind, though, by Emma Kennedy. She did a great job to bat that ball away from Drinan. Down to 5 seconds left in the third quarter. Skip down to Dre, and she's going to miss the easy one underneath. A tip and a make, though, and that's a tough break for the Clan because it's an N1 opportunity for Bailey Olson at the free throw line with no time left on the third quarter clock. And I can tell you, watching the high school games today, I watched in a 16-team tournament, I watched a 15-16 place game today. And you might think there might not be that much excitement there. But I watched this girl, Grace Killen. She got fouled with no time on the clock in regulation. Her team down by three, and she knocked down three straight free throws to force overtime. And the Centennial Centaurs actually went on to beat Elisa Homer's old school, Handsworth, in that game in overtime. So fun all around, fun here at the West Gym after three quarters. 79-44, I'm Howard Samura. We'll be back with more the fourth quarter upcoming on Clan TV.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship. Found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
And we're back with you at the West Gym, Howard Samura. Your play-by-play announcer on Clan TV for the Simon Fraser Clan and the St. Martin Saints in GNAC women's basketball action. Simon Fraser coming in at 6-1, the St. Martins at 1-6, and the record's indicative in that score right now, 79-44, all Simon Fraser. And a quick look at some of the numbers. Simon Fraser shooting 64% from the field, 32 of 50. Leading scorers, three in double figures, Meg Wilson with 21 points, Rachel Fradley with 16, and Elisa Homer with 12. And 10 points apiece from Mercedes Johansson and Bailey Olson. There's a bucket there for Mercedes Victor. So Victor knocks down a jumper there. Staying in the game at the point guard position is Taylor Drinan, the freshman out of Tacoma. Here is a three ball from Homer off the front of the iron. Taylor Jackson tried to squeeze it, couldn't. Loose ball on the floor. Homer dives on it. Loose ball. Taylor Jackson on the floor. Great job to get it to Sam Beauchamp. And Taylor Jackson with a great hustle play there to keep the ball alive for the Clan. Ball skipped to Taylor underneath, and she can't get to it. And bodies crashing to the floor. Taylor, a physical few minutes here on the floor, and she's going to get called for the foul, her second of the game. Tia Sang quickly off the bench will come into the game, as well as Rachel Fradley. Homer and Taylor Jackson coming out of the game. So right now it's Swant, Beauchamp, Drinan, Fradley, and Sang on the floor for the Clan. We've lost our monitor again, so. It's an Olympian task for me to fix this, I'll say to my producer-engineer, Gabe Lynn, and he knows what I mean. Samantha Beauchamp, with a great job underneath, gets the layup. So 81-46. Sammy Joe Robinson, Mercedes Victor now driving into the paint. The whistle blows quickly. And the foul being called against Rachel Fradley. So Fradge's second foul of the game. She's had a terrific outing, as has Meg Wilson. Sam Beauchamp for that matter too, especially on the defensive end of the floor. So the Simon Fraser front court, a great night here as Johansson swirls on the turnaround and can't get it going. And I got to apologize, I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm finding a way to, I'll just sit nicely still. Oh, I think I see what the problem is. I think I see what I need to do next time. So hopefully that'll keep us on the air here. I know you guys don't need to hear about our technical difficulties, so I'll get off of that in a real hurry. 8:24 left in our contest. Simon Fraser started this homestand on Thursday with that big win over Seattle Pacific, and they have not relented in terms of their focus here tonight. Beauchamp underneath the basket. Sam gets fouled on the way to the hole, and that foul is going to get called against Bailey Olson. But this is a real confidence-building game for Samantha Beauchamp. Came in here as a freshman and really got a great opportunity to learn and play a lot of minutes last season. And here she makes the first free throw. Great form on that shot by Sam there, 82-46. Knocks down the second. So Beauchamp getting it done and a big smile on her face, the former Holy Cross Crusader. Helen Kett and Meg Wilson set the check back into this contest. Simon Fraser men also are on the road tonight. Don't know if we're going to get a score passed down, but potentially we can let you know about what the Simon Fraser men are doing tonight. Set to shoot some free throws now for St. Martin's as Sammy Jo Robinson. She'll make the first. And the second free throw now is going to fall, and it is a 83-48 score. For Simon Fraser, some good opportunities to work on combinations, focus, things that haven't been going well, perhaps in practice, whatever they need to do. They've got a good opportunity here to really work on some things, keep fresh, and know that this St. Martin's team is not going to relent. They're going to keep coming. Here's Dryden with a shot on the base. Oh, check that cat. Shot doesn't go. The pass up top to Sang, and the over and back called a turnover there. Can pass on a men's basketball score at Concordia in Portland. The Clan men are trailing at this stage 69-41. So another tough night there for head coach Steve Hansen in his first year at the helm of the SFU men. And of course, the SFU men, what a great effort they put in against Western Washington before falling here on the home pine at the West Gym. Fortunately, that result hasn't resonated through their games that have followed immediately. And that was a solid, solid performance here. Really had the fans going in the West Gym against Western Washington. Simon Fraser now on the break. It's Wilson, recently checked into the game. Swant now with the basketball. Sophie, the drive, the dish to Sam up top to Ellen Kett. The cross court to Tia Sang for three. And the rookie knocks down a triple. Great for her confidence. And Tia knocks down the big three ball. Other end, trying to trade and get those three back. Hannah Reynolds with a miss. And here comes Sophie, driving down the floor to Wilson. Pulls it in with one hand, kicks it to Allen for the three, and off the back iron. Whistle blows, looks like something underneath the basket. So Meg Wilson gets called for the foul for a push. It's her third of the game, and we'll jump to a replay here on Clan TV as we watched that Tia Sang that three-pointer. And Ellen Kett's assist count. As we look at the numbers, Kett, I believe her 12th assist of the game. Don't know if it's a record-setting type of a night in line for Ellen Kett, but certainly one of the things in your environment you need to have happening is a great assist to made field goal ratio, and the Clan have that happening tonight. So at last count, 28 field goals, 22 made assists. And those are the kind of numbers that potentially help you get to conference standards. And Ellen Kent having another terrific game, the double-double for her. Ball tipped by Johansson, but stays with Wilson. She goes cross court to Kent for three. Ellen Kent for the three ball. And she knocks it down on the cross court pass from Meg Wilson. Klan can do no wrong. And they're going to get the ball back again after the turnover right in front of the St. Martin's bench. Bailey Olson unable to come in and corral that pass. So once again, take a look at the action as it unfolds here. The cross-court pass, and look at that classic form. Holds the release and knocks it down. Nothing but net for Ellen Kett. We're down to 6:14 remaining in this basketball game. Wilson to Swat. Sophie for three. Off the iron into the hands of Dre. And very quickly, St. Martin's McKenna Schultz across half court. Here's Johansson, jump stop in the paint. Crashing to the floor is Sophie Swant. And Sophie steps in and takes a very hard charge. She's feeling that one. She's being congratulated by her teammates, but she is feeling that one as she makes her way up the floor. Is number 21 out of Argyle Secondary School in North Vancouver. I watched the Pipers High School team play today. Among that group, Sophie's younger sister, Georgia, an excellent player with that Argyle team. Here's Johansson. Look at her stepping in front of Ellen Johansson. Sophie Swant knew she was going to get rocked to the ground, and indeed she was, but she creates the turnover. Johansson called for the foul. When you're willing to step in a 49-point game, that says something about you. Klan missing underneath, and very quickly again, McKenna Schultz across half court. Dre to Johansson, and here's the same part of the floor where she began her drive. This time she gets to the basket. A foul is going to get called. I believe it's either, no, it's going to be Rachel Fradgley. So as Fradge reached over, gets called for the foul. That's the exact same spot that Sophie simply stepped into the way of the driving Ellen Johansson and drew the charge. Johansson at the free throw line, makes the first. As we mentioned, leading this team in scoring at almost 17 points per game coming into play tonight. Beauchamp with the rebound. Kent long pass to Wilson. Works off the Sam screen to the corner. Vanessa G up top to Wilson, feeding the high post, and the turnaround shot there doesn't miss by much. Fradgley unable to score it. A Simon Fraser foul called against Beauchamp. '89-52, and St. Martin's getting their share of opportunities here at the free throw line. We're nearing the midway mark of the fourth quarter. A miss on the second, a rebound by Fradgley, and here's Kett quickly up the floor. Vanessa G to Meg Wilson. Meg Wilson approaching her career. She's got 21 points in this game, as our stat man Zahid Valley Hassan points out. Career high is 23, so Meg's had one of those nights, and thanks a lot for that big number. Don't know if Meg will be on the floor long enough to realize that, but certainly she's been so productive. Schultz with a basketball now. Geet G guarding her. They'll go to Johansson on the baseline by Fradgley. Back up top for the three. And it's going to bounce over the back of the goal. And the shot hoisted there by Rebecca Bau. So a timeout on the floor. Think about that. Meg Wilson, 23 points. If she can get there, would equal a career high. And it's been a terrific night. But if you are new to Klan TV, watching Meg Wilson and the kind of player she is, if you're just talking about the offensive side of the ball, my gosh, with that 6'1 strength and athleticism, what she's able to do is quite incredible. And one of the hoops that stands out is a bullet pass down into the post. Another one that really stands out is driving against a guard, keeping stride for stride and using her body at the end to out-muscle her way to the basket. What can she do? She's knocked down the three ball. We're just talking about the offensive side of the ball. Whatever you want a guard slash forward to do, if you want to say what is a guard slash, picture in the dictionary, because she's done it all tonight. And some fresh stats to bring you up to date on what's happening here. We'll first jump to Ellen Kett's numbers and find out that she has 13 assists in this game. She's got 11 points and 13 assists, only one rebound tonight for Ellen Kett. A couple of steals, but only one turnover in 27 minutes of play. So another solid effort there. Meg Wilson is 9 of 11, including 3 of 4 from three-point range. She hasn't gotten a free throw trip, which is a little interesting, but 21 points for her, 16 for Fradgley on 8 of 11 from the field. And Ellen, Elisa Homer, has hit 4 triples. She's 4 of 5 from beyond the arc and has 12 points. Oh, Wilson getting close to equaling that career mark there. Unable to finish right at the basket. Here's Drynan. Cross-court pass to Meg Wilson. Catch and shoot by Fradgley. Nice form, doesn't fall for her as Meg goes crashing into the back of the goal trying to save the basketball. Taylor Jackson now will check into the game. She'll spell Fradgley. And Meg's still in the game. Not sure if the Klan bench is even aware of the record. But we'll see what happens over the final 3:49. Saints will move it around. Kessler up top. Schultze, tough reverse, won't go for her. And here comes Dryden. G up top to Wilson. Back to Taylor Drynan. Wilson thought about a triple there. She'll bring it back up top. Reset with Taylor for the three. Drynan off the marker, doesn't draw any iron. Sub into the game now for St. Martin's. It's going to be Shyler Sullivan, number 21. Out of the game, number 12, Bailey Olson. Schultz running the point. She'll get it back. You're down to 3 minutes remaining. Dre thought about a long shot there. Instead, they'll work it around the horn, drive on the baseline, and get it right back to Dre in post-up position. She wants Kessler for the three, and she will get the roll. So Mallory Kessler, the sophomore out of Ritzville, Washington, knocks down the triple. 89-55, the score. Foul being called against Schultz. We can bring you up to date on the upcoming games here in just a moment here on Klan TV. We'll get down to 2:34 remaining because we hope you'll stick with us with this great Simon Fraser Klan women's basketball season. But right now, the Saints in command with the basketball. Dre, who's had a solid game. Rebecca Baugh, number 13, kicks it back up top, and the three ball from Dre misses the rim completely. Skip pass down low for Wilson. It's going to bounce out of her hands and go out of bounds. And Simon Fraser, we can let you know, on Tuesday, is going to be playing Western Washington here at the West Gym. You've got to come out and see it. It is Simon Fraser's best rivalry in the GNAC, and it will be loud and it will be fun. 7 o'clock here on Tuesday. Then on Thursday, Montana State Billings in the West Gym for a contest. And Montana State Billings struggling through the season near the lower reaches of the GNAC standings, but always, always competitive here atop Burnaby Mountain. And that's going to be a Thursday 7:30 start. So Tuesday, 7 o'clock against Western Washington. Thursday, 7:30 against Montana State Billings as the Klan round out their four-game homestand here at the West Gym. At the free throw line now, it's McKenna Schultz. Simon Fraser certainly not hurting itself in the improvement, the defensive stats here within the GNAC. They have limited, they have made St. Martin's earn everything. Just try and think about how many easy baskets St. Martin's has had in this game. They'd have a hard time just using one hand here to count those. There have not been a lot. Here's G to Beauchamp. Wilson baseline, goes back to Sam who can't control it, but Taylor Jackson there quickly. Drinan back to Taylor for three. Jackson, off the mark, misses the rim as the Saints get back down the floor with Schultz behind the back against Drinan. Swatted by Jackson, but I believe Taylor will get called for the foul. So Taylor Jackson gets called for the foul in the attempt that blocks you ran the floor hard. Trying to get a stop at the other end of the court. Taylor's third foul of the game, and now Schultz. We can quickly bring you up to date on a women's score. Western Washington, with 4:58 remaining, leads Seattle Pacific by 10, 53-43. And we thank Saheed Valley Hassan for that update, because if both of these scores hold, the two teams would continue to remain in a two-way tie for second place in the GNAC standings. That is provided Alaska Anchorage doesn't lose, whoever they're playing tonight. So there's Schultz with a jump shot, or rather a free throw, a make there. Western and Simon Fraser, it speaks for itself, even without the records. But bring in 2-7-1 teams conceivably on Tuesday, and that is a huge, huge basketball game in the scheme of the GNAC Women's Basketball Conference at the upper reaches. So circle Tuesday on your calendar, 7 o'clock here at the West Gym. The jumper by Drinan goes, and Taylor knocks down the shot there. That's a triple for Drinan. I believe her second of the game. So the Gonzaga prep rookie knocks down the triple in the final minute of play. Here's Schultz, skip on the baseline. Turnaround shot by Kessler, doesn't find the range. Dre battling. Turns into a baseline jumper that will fall, and that's number 21, Schuyler Sullivan. So Sullivan finishes off the play as we get down to, there's about half a second difference between game and shot here with 19 seconds remaining. So Meg will dribble it out. I don't think she's going to reach her career high, but not important here tonight on a big night as Simon Fraser does a great job in the GNAC, and that's going to do it. 92-61, it's a 31-point victory for the home team, the Simon Fraser University Clan. What a performance here tonight, spread out through the lineup, but especially from Meg Wilson, who had an outstanding game. You can circle a number of them, but I think Meg would be the first star of this game. As always, Ellen Kett, super solid. Samantha Beauchamp, a great game as well. Rachel Fradgley as well. So many of them, and they all step up big, and that's why the Clan are sitting where they're sitting right now with a 16-2 overall record and a 7-1 record in the GNAC. It's the eighth straight victory for the Simon Fraser University Clan. We hope you enjoyed the broadcast. For Sports Information Director Steve Frost, for our Executive Producer Gabriel Lynn, Saheed Valley Hashim on the Media Row with the stats, I'm Howard Samura. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back with you again on Tuesday when Simon Fraser hosts Western Washington.